I'm going to briefly describe how to use the interactive simulation for reverse osmosis. And so what this simulation displays is on the left side is a graph of water flux versus pressure drop across the membrane. So this membrane, and the figure in the right represents the system. Membrane is only permeable to water, not to salt. So we feed salt water into the membrane, and our objective is to get pure water out, and as a result we concentrate salt water, so we're leaving with a higher concentration. And the reason this works is because we have a large pressure difference, in this case 40 atmospheres pressure difference. We have to have a pressure higher than this osmotic pressure to get flow through the membrane. And what we can do is we can, in the sliders, if I change the pressure drop, then I'm moving this black dot to a different location just so we can see what the flux would be for that pressure drop. If I change the stirring speed, then I'll reduce concentration polarization and I'll get a higher flux of water through the membrane. So this green curve will move as I change the stirring speed. If I change the inlet salt concentration, then I'm going to change the osmotic pressure, and therefore that affects how much flow I'll get through the membrane. And if I uncheck this box at the top that says show diagram, then I'll remove this diagram on the right, and I'll just get a bigger figure of the graph to make it easier to see the behavior. So let's look at now the actual simulation. So here's the simulation. If I increase the pressure drop, you'll notice, of course, the black dot moves, but also notice I'm changing the numbers on the right side. So this diagram on the right side corresponds to conditions for the black dot. So for example, if I were to lower the pressure drop enough, now I no longer have reverse osmosis, but I have osmosis. And notice the permeate flow rate is negative. And so I actually am pulling pure water through the membrane because the chemical potential is higher. Now let's go back to reverse osmosis. If I increase the stirring bar speed, then I'm decreasing the concentration polarization, and I increased the flux for the same pressure drop. And of course, if I increase the salt concentration, I'm changing what the osmotic pressure is, and I'm lowering the flux through the membrane for a given pressure drop because I'm lowering the chemical potential of water on the feed side. And so last thing to show you here is if I remove the checkbox here, then I'm just showing the graph on a larger scale to make it a little easier to visualize what's happening in this system. And I'm lowering the salt and showing that I can get increased water flux through the membrane.